Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Tuesday. I almost said Friday because this is the season finale. This is wrapping up the BTS for not only the fall of this year, but also this year entirely. So that has me thinking a lot about wrapping up and casting forward. You know, if we look back on the year that has been, what are our creative feats? What are the things that happened that had a huge impact on our lives and our creative lives? What are the things that we are most proud of? What are the things that we are happy to leave behind? You know, and then looking forward, what kind of a new year are we going to create? What is our intention? What is the energy? We are sitting here looking at the year ahead and we're sending energy out to it. We're already filling that empty studio with colors and thoughts and moods and emotions and our word of the year. What kind of year are we already starting to create? If you stop and think about that and you realize you're already deep in worry or tightness or control or anything that makes you feel less than about next year, see if there are some adjustments you can make. Maybe that's not the energy you want to bring into the next year. Maybe you want to let go of some of those plans. Maybe you want to envision something that's the opposite of where you are starting. Now is the time. Now is the time to start thinking about it. I think about in planning day, one of the things we do is, you know, every person decides for themselves how detailed or how open they want to leave their year, their season, their schedule. And for me, I like to have a tone. I like to have several projects that I hope to bring to life, but I never schedule them all in tightly because there's no question that when it comes to that time, I'll have some fresh and new response to what is going on, and I may want to grab it and do that instead. And there's an aliveness to that that I think is really important. I was thinking yesterday about why do so many of us want to live a creative life, and what do we mean by that, and what's the impact of that? And I think at the heart, it is an instinct that we have for aliveness. You know, our spirits, our bodies, our energy wants to be alive. it's nature. And so for some of us, creativity is the road into that aliveness. It's where we feel most awake and energized and engaged. It's what reminds us of who we are. And that matters because this life is our unique experience of this spirit. And creativity is such a profound and powerful way for us to express that. And so I love. I love when I meet people and they are so truly who they are. And I love seeing what people create and how it tells us something about their mind and their heart and their colors and their preferences and their choices. And for me, that is a celebration of life. It is a celebration of spirit. And so for me, this is the heart of the work. You know, if I teach a class on creating a junk journal, it's not just about creating a junk journal. It's about how does creating a junk journal bring you alive? How does creating a junk journal tell you something about who you are? How can creating a junk journal bring out of you who you are and allow you to share it in the world through what you create? for me, this is what it's all about. And we have had some wonderful sharings of what people create. We have had a season of cats, and I have several more to share with you today. Meow, meow. Oh my goodness, there's cats in there. Meow. Rocking the reading glasses. Okay, we've got something here from Simone. Oh, in Scarborough. Hey, neighbor. Thanks for sending this, Simone. I'm so excited to see what you have sent. Oh, look at this. Simone. Whoops. What a beauty. Isn't that sweet? Oh, let's see what she says. She's really loved this theme this season, and she follows my kitten corner faithfully. Yay! She's written just lovely things in here. And I just want to share, too, that if you're not a member of the studio, which, why not? Come on over to openthedoor.ca and join. And in the newsletter, every Sunday at the bottom, I have a little kitten corner, and I share a photo and often a little story of one or all of the studio kittens, Escher, Shibumi, and Scout. This is so beautiful. I absolutely love it, and I will be putting it up on the board. Thanks, Simone. Okay, and here's the next one, which is from Lori. And look at, Lori has made this wonderful envelope herself from magazines. What a great idea and a total treat. And this has wonderful stamps too, including a hockey stamp. Which, you know what that means. That makes me think it's from Canada. But it actually says USA forever on it. Hey! All right, Lori, let's see what you have. Oh, look at this. A pumpkin pie cat. This is Pumpkin the kitty, who tired of listening to all of the yakking going on after dinner and was ready to enjoy some dessert. So she did. She created this the day before the U.S. Thanksgiving holiday and clearly considered Pumpkin Kitty a kindred spirit. This was made with gel pen, watercolor, stamps, and a magazine. Oh, it's beautiful. Pumpkin and her pie. Thank you, Lori. And Pumpkin is the last of our cats for the season. I want to say thank you too for everyone who sent me a birthday card. Thank you so much. They're more personal, so I'm just keeping them for myself. But thank you so much to everybody who thought of me for my birthday and sent that along. So now it is time to announce the winter theme for our bulletin board. And that theme is going to be stars. So, for example, here's one I made. You can go super simple like me. I actually made this collage paper myself. Oh, you know what? I like the other side too. Oh, I think I might like the other side more. Yes, I think this is it. Though I might do some edges around it or play with it a little bit. So it can be a cutout star like this. It could be a scene with stars. Anything star inspired will be a part of our winter bulletin board theme. I'm loving the idea that throughout the winter that this board will just be covered with stars. And it makes me think that it's like all of you, you know, like it'll be like our own little constellation of us up on the board. And I hope you find stars very unintimidating, but still inspiring. And so I hope you will create a star for me this winter. And remember that the first star, I love that, the first star that shows up for this season becomes our bit of featured art that will always be at the end of the video along with our address. So that's the theme. Thank you for all the cats. I have loved them. They have been magnificent company. Now I am looking forward to a sky full of stars for this winter. And if you watch Start Creating As We Go, the show I do with my sisters, and yesterday we did it live and we had so much fun. I'll put a link to the recording. It was just great. Great. We absolutely loved it and immediately thought, hey, we should do this more often. But if you watch not that episode, but the episode before, you will have seen this. I had this idea that what I would like to do with all of this art is to create a kind of memory book, a kind of portfolio art gallery of all the pieces that have been sent in. And if you've been around for a while, you know that we started with birds. So here's another bird. And I love that because I put, do you see? I put that one there because it says, for Jamie. So I thought that was a beautiful title page. And my plan is to do a flip through for you. We have done birds, we have done flowers, we have done unicorns, and we have done cats. Does that mean we've done a year? I think we started off as a monthly theme, so it's probably a little less than a year. But this, I thought this would be a fun way to really honor all the work that everybody has done. So I'm going to put the cats in, and then I am going to do a flip through for you. So I hope that feels exciting. What an exciting year we've had together. I can't believe I've been doing the BTS this long, when it just really started as me waking up one morning and saying, hey, do you know what would be cool? Some of my favorite ideas have started off with, hey, do you know what would be cool? I like to leave my schedule and my plans for the next year just flexible enough to make room for, hey, do you know what would be cool? But one thing I know would be cool is for you to join me again in the new year. I will be back in January, likely January 16th. If you want to know for sure, again, head on over to openthedoor.ca. Join the studio, then you'll always be apprised of everything. And that reminds me, tomorrow, the Academy opens for the winter. So that's all of the winter classes, including Journal Club. The registration will be open tomorrow. And if you join the studio, you get 10% off all of the classes all the time. So be sure to check that out. I feel like I want to go around the room and hug everybody. I feel like I want to look into your eyes and tell you how much you mean to me and how much it matters to me that you're here and that you're committed to creating, to making, to bringing yourself alive, to bringing that creative energy, that aliveness to yourself, to your life, and to the world. It matters. It matters to the whole world. Imagine a world rich with people who were creatively alive. So, you know, as you go about your day today, as you encounter people, so if you don't encounter anybody today, keep this practice with you, you know, through the weekend, as you encounter people, as you get on the subway, as you go for a walk, as you go to work, look around the room and think, what if all of these people were creatively alive? It doesn't mean that they'd all want to be artists, but they would be more engaged. They would be curious. They would be full of wonder. They would be offering up ideas and open to possibilities. Imagine what would be different. I say this more in the spirit of letting you know what your impact will be as more and more every day you bring your creativity to life, because I know that's why you're here. I know that's why you're watching. And if I could ask you to do one thing, if I could inspire you to do one thing from now until when I'm back, so that's a month. So that's a really good amount of time to do something. Don't just think about creating. Don't just talk about creating. Don't just journal about creating. Spend some time in creativity. Pull out your markers, pull out your watercolors, pull out some clay, pull out some Play-Doh, turn on some music, dance, sing, move. This is the time. Now is always the time. Have you ever heard that wonderful saying, the best time to plant a tree was 200 years ago, the second best time is now. Now is the time to lessen that rift between you and your creative heart. And as, even if you're a person who's creating all the time, you know what it's like when you create all the time and you still, it looks to everyone else like you are in this great creative aliveness, but you're in routine, you're in habit, you're exhausted, you're doing what you think people want from you, not what you want to create. If that's your scenario, then the invitation is the same. Get back over the next month to your art, your love, your spontaneity, your impulses, your artistic intuition. Make something that is just by you and for you. So that's my call to you over the next month until the BTS comes back, is express your creative heart. Get into action. I'm still working in the studio. The academy will be ready tomorrow. A new winter studio will be here on the weekend for those of you who are members. I'll be wrapping things up and taking a bit of a break, making my vision cards. I have my plan. I feel ready for the new year. I hope you feel ready too. Planning day and vision cards will both be available in the winter studio. So don't feel like you've missed out on that. I really want you to be able to start your new year full of inspiration, intention, and openness to magic. I'll see you in the new year. Hey everybody, it is the first real snow and I am out for my walk. And it is so exciting that I wanted to share it with you.